Good evening, I'm Brittany Nielsen. We begin tonight with the Central Coast newly appointed National Park wrapping up its first weekend with the new designation. The Pinnacles was known for more than a century as a monument, but joined elite company Thursday when President Obama named it the newest of the country's 59 national parks. Action News reporter Tom Miller is live at the Pinnacles National Park tonight with more on how this change is affecting visitors and the South Monterey County economy. Tom?
Brittany, last year there were about 300,000 visitors who visited this park here, and some predictions have that number doubling in the years ahead. So now, after an influx of tourists this weekend, some local businesses and communities are doing what they can to prepare for what will likely be the new normal around here. The trails are packed and parking lot full as visitors flock to the Pinnacles to check out America's newest national park.
When I heard, I just kind of thought, okay, well, we should go and just see it.
Park ranger Nicole Andler has heard similar stories all day, mainly from people who live close by. She says as word gets out, expect international tourists to start showing up more.
When they come to visit America, they take a look at what national parks are in this area that we're going to. Let's go see them.
That's what the Inn at the Pinnacles is preparing for, too.
The fact that it's a park will mean probably more foreign visitors for us.
But the Inn could soon face competition from the city of Soledad, which is using the Pinnacles' upgraded status as a peg to lure in an upscale hotel chain. Mayor Fred Ledesma says the city is also in talks with a marketing firm to brand the city as a gateway to the park.
Goose laid a golden egg, so it's up to you to do something with that gold now.
And there's a lot they'll have to sell. One-of-a-kind spires formed millions of years ago. The rock climbing that goes with it.
Flaky and
stunning ice formations. And of course, world-class bird watching, where every so often, the endangered and elusive California condor makes an appearance. In addition to that, on the west end, it's these caves where you need a light to get through that's the big attraction. And in winter time, when it's so cold, ice in here is a big concern for people trying to get in and out. Meanwhile, everything that now says National Monument is being updated.
We were about to finish up the new park film, and everything said National Monument. So we've stopped that. They're going back and changing everything to National Park.
Most of the signage will change next week. All finishing touches as Pinnacles settles into its new role as one of the country's premier parks. And one sign that won't be changing for about a month is this one behind me, as the National Park Service needs more time to find the right piece of wood and the right woodworker to make a new one. Brittany?
Tom, thank you so much. Now, Pinnacles was first named a national monument back in 1908 by President Theodore Roosevelt, the same day the Grand Canyon was declared a national monument.